just need to get rid of all this shit. Hey everyone, welcome to DIY in 5. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and in this episode, we're going to teach you how to clean up some disk space in Windows 10 to speed up that machine. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe for more ways to speed up your system. If your disk is almost full, one of the cheapest and easiest ways to get some performance back is free up space. The fastest way to do that is empty the recycle bin. What's that, you say? You deleted lots of large files already, but your disk is still full? Well, your PC didn't actually delete them, it just moved them to the recycle bin. To give them the final heave-ho, just right-click on your recycle bin and click on empty recycle bin. But be sure you are 100% okay with deleting those files, because now they are gone for good. What if you've got a bunch of movies, photos, and other files you still want to keep? Don't delete them, just move them. For those of you who already have a second hard drive, that's really easy. But what if you don't? There are so many options for storing files. You can use this, or even this thing. And of course, you can't forget about the cloud storage. No nudie files on the cloud though, am I right, J-Law? Now that you've emptied the recycle bin and moved some of those files you wanna keep, but you still need more room, what's next? Windows 10 has a handy feature called Disk Cleanup. In the Start menu, go to All Apps, Windows Administrative Tools, Disk Cleanup. Here you can go through and check what types of files you want to remove. Your system holds on to lots of temporary files, error logs, thumbnails, etc. that can be quickly removed. Keep an eye out for Windows ESD files, though, as these are used to reset your system if you ever get in a jam. Disk Cleanup can free up gigabytes of data pretty quickly, depending on how often you clean out your system. The last tip we'll mention has to do with the Hibernate feature on Windows 10. It's turned on by default and allows your PC to quickly turn on after shutting down or going to sleep. Hibernate takes a snapshot of your drivers and system files and saves it to your hard drive. This file can be quite large. It allocates up to 75% of your system RAM size for this file. So if you have 8 gigs of RAM installed, your Hibernate file can be up to 6 gigs. If you're really eager for some extra space, this is a good option. So what other Windows questions do you have? Have you ever wondered where Clippy went? I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and thank you for watching DIY in 5. Also, these other Windows tips videos are pretty cool, just saying.